Teenagers are skipping meals, sleep and their homework to spend more time online. And according to new Netsafe research, they're also fighting more with friends and whānau because of time spent surfing the net. Chief Executive Martin Cocker of Netsafe joins us now with more. Morena.
Good morning.
This seems worrying, and in your research it says 47% say very often or sometimes people have conflict with their family and their friends over the internet.
Yeah, and I think that's the thing that you find when you talk to parents, that they say, oh, you know, I gave that device and they won't get off it, and then it leads to, you know, fights and they won't come to dinner, that sort of thing. So it's good to do this research and to find out that that is actually, you know, incredibly common. The other thing that's important is this is, you know, research where we surveyed 14 to 17 year olds. So this is in their own opinion. So this is not parents saying the devices cause problems. This is teenagers themselves saying our time online leads to these problems for us.
Do you think that because it's self-reporting that the problem might be worse than actually you found?
Well, certainly when you think of something like negatively impacting your education, yeah, I mean, it's hard to accept that in the first place and then sometimes even to see it. But for, you know, a quarter of a third of people to say that they, you know, it did affect their education, then that shows that young people recognise their time online is not always good for them. And, you know, it does open the door for parents to say, hey, we could do something about this.
Well, what can they do?
Yeah, so I say it opens the door. It opens the door because if young people are admitting, if young people are admitting that it's a problem, then that's a lot easier to deal with them. I think in the end, you know, parents have to accept that they have to control, to some extent, access online. So they have to set limits and enforce those. And I know that's, you know, that's really hard.
Almost impossible, right?
I know that's really hard. But if you are one of the, you know, 10% of young people who are often having problems as a result of it, then you're really looking for your parents to help you out. And I think it's really important for parents to recognise also that not all time online is the same. So, you know, sometimes we'll be playing games. Sometimes they'll...
Excuse me, God, sorry.
You're right. Sometimes they'll be playing games, sometimes they'll be doing homework. And the other thing, we're not saying that time online is harmful because it's time online. We're saying it's harmful because of what it's impacting elsewhere.
Now, some people say that being online, social media especially, is addictive. Yeah. So it's all very well to set boundaries and to put some rules around the usage, but and even if you recognise that it's a problem yourself, how do you actually stop using it too much?
Yeah, so I don't know, like, the word addictive is a very strong word to use, but these software like social media is designed to keep your attention. Games are designed to keep your attention.
I would say I'm addicted to it, and I don't even like it.
I'm worried I am too.
Yeah, and I just scroll, like, I would say that.
Okay, this feels like it's going to be a very serious session between us to deal with this particular issue.
Right.
But we're, like, certainly talking about young people, if it is an issue, then somebody else is going to have to step in. If you're saying you're addicted, that's basically you saying, I can't deal with this myself. I need somebody else to help me to deal with this.
Okay.
You know, obviously for adults, and I agree that a lot of adults do have trouble. They are very distracted by their devices. They are drawn to that software all the time, or to those services all the time. But, you know, your parents are unlikely to step in on your behalf.
Sure. So what can parents actually say?
What can they say?
Yeah, what can they do?
Well, I think that's important to, like, have this conversation about the time that young people spend. Like, just sit down and talk to them about it. How much time do you spend on the different things? You know, what do you think the impact is? If you're lucky, your child will say to you, look, I spend too much time doing these things and it's having a negative impact, and that'll make it easy. If you're not, you're going to have to, you know, you're going to have to lay that out. And then, you know, just set rules. I mean, you know, you can have really formal setting of rules. You can have a document. Netsafe has one of those to download. Or you can sort of do it informally. You can just discuss it and then, you know, keep coming back to that conversation. But you just need to address it and then constantly sort of keep coming back to it.
You want to model good behaviour of your own.
Oh, absolutely,
well, right?
Modelling, yeah. Parents are, that's one of the things that we see all the time. You know, we say to young people, put the device down, but we're scrolling through our emails at the dinner table. And it's important to note the person on the other side doesn't know how important whatever you're dealing with is. So you may very well be dealing with important stuff, but if you don't tell your child, I'm on the phone because this is an emergency at work, they're just going to think you're scrolling through the phone, you're a hypocrite.
Yeah, right. Now, if you can't address all of the time and however long they're spending on it, can you at least try and get them to eat? If you say some people are not eating, can you at least try and get them to try and sleep?
Yeah, I think definitely for young people, and for everybody, but definitely for young people, you know, you've got to force them to eat. You've got to get them to eat, and you've got to get them to sleep, because, you know, if you're not eating and sleeping, then that's going to affect other aspects of your life, and certainly your education. And so, you know, for many parents, they resort to, like, literally taking the devices away at night and putting them in a basket or something like that, so they cannot disturb young people at night.
Sure. Thank you so much for your time this morning, Martin Cocker from Netsafe, and sorry about the distraction.
Right. You've got a cold. You can't help that. It is fascinating. I think we have to lead by example, don't we? I'm really now becoming aware of just putting my damn phone down, especially when I'm with my children. It's disgraceful how often my children are talking to me and I'm looking at Twitter or something. What the hell is that about? Yeah. So I've got to do better. And I think we stayed somewhere without Wi-Fi over the holidays, and it was amazing. You know, you go cold turkey on your phone, and then suddenly you're doing life without it.
And suddenly you're looking up,
and you're noticing the day and the world.
There are people who recommend just taking a break on a regular basis and say that's pretty good for you. And I think it's something to try if it works for you.
And definitely they recommend that an hour before you sleep, that no screen time. So put your phones down an hour before you plan to go to bed. That's very hard for some people. I know one person, mum, wakes up and checks your phone in the middle of the night. Bad.
Many people do.
Yeah. Thanks, mum. Nice to see you. Okay. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too.